In this video, I'm gonna show you an easy way to cut to the rhythm of the beat within Premiere Pro utilizing a technique called Automate to Sequence. This essentially allows you to create markers on your timeline, and then in your project bin, you can create your in and outs and import that footage directly to the timeline to those markers. I've already imported my music track down here, and I want to move my playhead to the beginning of the timeline and start creating my markers. Now, it's important to create a marker right here on the very first frame, because when you import your footage, it uses that very first marker as the first place to insert the footage. You can click this little icon to add a marker, but you can also hit the letter M to create a marker, which I think is much faster. So now that we have our first marker in, what I want to do is actually listen to the music, and I'll hit M as the music is playing and create my markers that way. I think I'll leave it right there. Now, before we import these into the timeline, we want to make sure that they start at the right place, and that's creating our ins and outs. Now, you may be familiar with this, so if I were to double click on a clip, that brings it up in the source monitor. Say I just wanted to create my in when they're kind of throwing this glowy ball up. So I can hit I on the keyboard to create my in point. And as it goes away, I'll hit O to create my out point. So when I drag this clip down to the timeline, there's my in, there's my out. In order to do it the fastest way, I think, is to open this up and use your icon view. Currently, we're looking at our footage bin in list view, but if we go to this icon, it's icon view. I'll click that, but I want to make this window full screen, and I can do this by hovering the mouse over this specific bin and hitting the tilde key on the keyboard. So I'm going to hit that. To make these even bigger, I'm going to go down here to adjust my size of the icons in the thumbnails. Now we have a lot of room to work with. To set our ins and outs in the footage bin, all you have to do is hover scrub on the footage and use that same process of hitting I to set your in and O to set your out. Let's say I want to have her running up, so I'll hit I on my keyboard. And it's really tough to see if you don't know it's there, but down below is the playhead. So notice where I'm moving the mouse. Right here is the playhead on the clip. So anything that's blue will become your clip. So there I created my in point. So I'll go to about right here and hit my out point. Now, the beauty of automating your sequence the way that we're going to be doing it, you don't necessarily need to set out points, because the out points for these clips are basically going to be cut off by another clip coming in by the next marker. So if I go to this next clip with this guy, let's say we want this little intense shuffle that he's doing, I'll just hit I, move on to the next clip. Her doing these hand gestures where I want to start, move on to the next clip. I'll continue on with this technique until this clip right here. Let's say, for example, you wanted two ins and out points on the same clip. In order to do that, let's say I want to do one part this throwing ball and another one where they're kind of dancing like this back and forth. I'll create one in and out point surrounding that ball throwing motion. And then to create another instance of an in and out point, all I need to do is right click and duplicate that clip. So now I have two instances of this clip, but on this second clip over here, I can move the playhead over to where they're dancing back and forth and create my new endpoint. I'll hit I, notice that the line has changed down here. These two are now the same clip, but they start at different times. This clip starts right here where they're throwing the ball. This clip starts where they are dancing back and forth. There's also a different way to do this technique. And instead of going to duplicate, you could go to make subclip. And you could just restrict the clip to the subclip boundaries, whichever way is best and most efficient for your workflow. Once you have your ins and outs set, the next step is to order the clips in which you want them to appear on the timeline. So if I were starting over here from the left, this will be the first clip, this will be the next clip coming in, so on and so forth. Now that I have my clips organized, I'll hit the tilde key to restore the bin to its original size. Move my playhead to the very beginning of the timeline again, because when I go to import these, it's going to start it from wherever the playhead is. With all of your footage in the right order, I'm going to highlight all of my clips. I can do that by hitting Command A on Mac or Control A on Windows. And now we want to bring up our Automate to Sequence window. You can do that by going up to Clip, Automate to Sequence, or even better, there's an icon right here by the magnifying glass, Automate to Sequence. I'm going to click this one. For ordering, we want to do Selection Order. For placement, we want to make sure that we're using our unnumbered markers. We want to overwrite the edit. And for this specific example, we want to ignore the audio. If you didn't do this, it may paste the audio over your music layer. And if you do need to import it with the audio, just make sure that the track targeting for that music track is turned off. That way, the audio from your clips doesn't paste over your music. But for right now, I'm going to ignore my audio so I don't have to worry about that. So I'll hit okay. And immediately we have our clips down here on the timeline. There may be a little bit that you need to adjust. That's not too hard to fix. And the final product looks something like this. Hey you, if this video was helpful, don't forget to leave me that thumbs up. If you're curious on other audio tips within Premiere Pro, I have a video about that right here, and the robots that are taking our jobs that algorithmically want to show you the best video that you would probably click more than that video, it's right there. So you could click either of those and we could spend some more time with each other. Until next time, my name's Javier Mercedes, and I hope you're out there living a life of abundance. Bye.